can always
read
that.
You can
always read
that.
Yeah,
I got to meet with no one calling. I thought it was...
As far back as I can remember, I've always wanted to go to the Bahamas.
I know I'd go from rags to riches if you would only say you care. And though my pocket may be empty,
hey Charlie, what's up?
I'd be a
millionaire. Not much. How'd you like to be in my my third vlog? There's Charlie. Charlie,
what's up?
What's up, man?
How you doing?
It's Charlie right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, it's normal now. I mean, with these millennials, it's just like, oh, there's just another vlogger, right?
Right.
I mean, this is like 5 years ago. You see somebody doing this, you think they're nuts.
I still get Bluetooth people.
Shoot, I've known you since, what was it, about
2005? Wellwood alive in 2005.
Yeah, Wellwood.
That's the street we lived on.
And so, that's 13 years.
Yeah.
And yeah, as you know, I'm in this this contest, but even the bigger picture, I'm starting this vlog, which, you know, even if I don't win, I still have these episodes and I can continue doing it,
yeah.
Which is cool. And you can kind of, you know, sky's the limit from there. You've seen what some of the big vloggers have done.
Oh, yeah. And yeah, we've seen your stuff before, yeah. You're pretty good at it.
So episode 3, interview somebody that's been kind of by your side along the poker journey, and here's Charlie.
Yeah, pretty much from day one that we met each other, since we've known each other.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, tell me about what poker means to you, or what...
What it means to me. It's just fun. I mean, it really is fun. Just always seeing if you can get better. It's, and I think another aspect of that helps with the mathematical side of your brain is that you're not playing the house when you play poker. You're playing the other people, and there's no automatic set. In the long run, you're going to lose type of scenario. Right now in Indianapolis, the scenario is charity gaming with the local nonprofits, like the Legions, the Shriners has a game, and what's the biggest game is the
Knights of Columbus.
Knights of Columbus, yeah. Biggest game in town.
So. Yeah, the Shriners is just across the street, and there is a ton of like professionals in the city that do it for a living because there's a game basically 24/7.
Yeah.
If you follow their chart, how would you describe my kind of playing style?
You have to tread carefully because you do set traps a lot is what I would say.
Yeah.
So I'm very leery to just go big on the turn or to try to bluff, especially, here's how I'm going to play. Now I'm giving away all the home games.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's always scary to raise you big on the river the turn with that because then if you call, that's usually a sign of that. I need to tread lightly, but I mean, you do put mix in bluffs too, so it's not,
okay.
Yeah, not.
I know. I try to kind of mix it up, but I have noticed coming from a tournament background, which I think that's a good starting point. And then all of a sudden, you know, I watch these vlogs and I see if you want to do it for a living, it's more grinding and cash games. And then I find these different games when I got back into it, and I wanted to play the best in the city like overnight. And I jump in there and I figured out the cash game, it's kind of a whole different style because you can't really push people around as much as I feel like deep in tournaments you can kind of steal blinds, you can steal pots. I mean, there'll be a guy calling with a gut shot all the way down to the river, and then he'll hit it on you.
Yeah.
But yeah, it seemed like cash game's a whole different animal, so.
Yeah, and we both, I think, were mainly tournament players. I think still, to the most degree we are. But yeah, that's where my bread and butter was in a tournament. You can put someone in a situation for their tournament life, and they're really thinking hard. You can use a bluff that way.
Start beer for the money. 2 hours. We're having a little home game. Hope you guys will be over. Hey, there's Ari back there.
I want to see.
You want to see?
Yeah.
Say hi. How old are you?
Two.
What's your name?
Ryan.
Hi, Ryan. And there's Ellie. She's the oldest, 8.
Fine.
She loves watching YouTube videos.
Yeah.
I think she wants her own channel.
Yeah.
And there's Ari. Had 2 girls and then had a boy. 8, 6, and 2. Boy, don't you want that candy? Where's it at?
It's gone. You ate all of it.
Oh no.
What's up? Can't have a poker vlog without going over at least one hand. So we're playing this little tournament at my house, 7 of us. Blinds are 3-6. Under the gun plus 1 makes it 20. The next guy calls. I look down at 9-7 of diamonds, go ahead and see a flop. I call. Flop comes jack 8-6, giving me an open-ended. Under the gun plus 1 makes it 40. The next 2 players call. I go ahead and make it 140. Thinking maybe I can weed out a couple people or take it down. All of them call. River, or the turn comes ace of diamonds, giving me the diamonds and the open-ended, all kinds of outs. Under the gun plus 1 pushes the rest of his stack about 150. Under the gun plus 2, Matt Vest, he's also a poker vlogger. I'll give a link in my description. He goes ahead and shoves, comes over to me, and the next guy folds, and I go ahead and push it in. So let's see what happens on the river here.
I guess I go all in too, whatever I got.
Just keep it in front of you.
All right, what do we got?
I got 2 pairs.
Fellas.
Two.
6.
Wait, what's the...
Oh, you didn't even flip the final card.
I know.
We're all in. Oh, we were all in.
I figured you had.
Yeah, I got.
And an opening.
Yeah.
Millions out.
Ace and 8.
You got better 2.
Holy crap!
Right now.
Yeah, you gotta kill that.
All right, so I need
2
a. I need a 5, a 10, or a diamond.
9, 10.
All right, here we go.
Or 6. I'm gonna die. You get there for me.
5. Straight. Straight.
Straight. You got it.
How much you got?
Oh, jeez.
Are you serious?
It's good for. Jeez.
Man. You had
a call.
Ow.
50. Dang, look at that pot.
How much did you have for
that? Oh, yeah, and by the way, my buddy Charlie's not playing poker. He's a professional singer.
London, I'm mobile, qual più mal vento, mutta d'accento e di pensiero.
Wow, that was something else. Can't believe he's just doing it right out here in public like that, but... That's why he's a pro. Beautiful.